後ろからです。次から。
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the speaker, Ms. Yugo Mori and Ms. Kisoko Mochizuki.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for assembling here today for a press conference, which I think will be very revealing and informative. We are at sort of many turning points, many junctures of pursuit of truth, interpretation of truth, methodology for the pursuit, etc., etc., all the debates that are ongoing. And many of those debates happening in Japan today were brought to the public attention through the hard work of our two guests. We have to my right Ms. Yuko Mori, member of the House of Councillors from the Liberal Party, and beside her Ms. Isoko Mochizuki, reporter from the Tokyo Shimbun. And to the far right we have our interpreter, Mary Joyce. So I think I don't need to ask anybody if you remember about that minor school problem that first came to our attention, seems like an eternity ago, called Kake and Moritomo. And it would probably not have made the news at all if it were not for the persistence of some very hard pursuing politicians and the journalist we have beside us today. And so I don't want to extend the introduction any further because they both have quite a story to tell. And just for your information, the book that they have just written is available at the front desk if you need more information, and I think it's very much worth looking into. So without further ado, we will first start the talk today with Ms. Mori. Yoroshiku omegai shimasu.
Thank you, kind introduction about us. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm great honor to be here, SCJ. So, my name is Yuko Mori, member of the House of Councillors from the Liberal Party. I have joined work Isoko Mochizuki, reporter with the Tokyo Shimbun, to write the book, Suikyūryo. Lovely translates as the ability to pursue problems. Our goal is to send a clear and strong message to Prime Minister Shinzo Abe that we refuse to tolerate any form of autocracy and will never stop our own pursuit of the truth. As you know, there are still no clear answers to the Moritomo and Kake school scandals. They went to Japanese paper. Okay. Thank you. At the National Diet last year, we had a steady stream of claims that there are no records. I have no memories. Nothing can be confirmed. Certainly, we can agree that there are no true government without records. There is also an unworkable explanation why so many of Japan's elite bureaucrats are suddenly suffering from acute memory loss. Today, in Japan, disposable income continues to decline, oppressing the lives of people. Therefore, we can only wonder why Mr. Abe's friends continue to receive such preferential treatment, or why government-owned land, the common property of all Japanese citizens, has been sold off at dirt cheap prices. We also saw how the Director General of the Financial Bureau of the Ministry of Finance at that time gave clearly bogus answers to diet questioning. That same director generator was subsequently promoted to be Director General of the National Tax Administration Agency. As such, he is now in charge of all tax collections. The fact that he continued to hold such a post today can be described as a terrible joke. We also have the case of Yasunori and Junko Kagoike, husband and wife, directors of Moritomo Gakuen School. Back when they were good buddies with Mr. and Mrs. Abe, they were apparently able to purchase state-owned land for next to nothing. Now, for nearly 6 months, despair has been held in prison cell without windows, banned from even seeing family members. It would appear that this has been done to keep them from telling what they know. Under Mr. Abe's authoritative control, meanwhile, the regulation was advanced on Japan's national strategy special zones, chosen as the first school of reality medicine to be newly established in Japan in 52 years was Kake Gakuen School. That school is operated by a trust friend of, yes, Shinzo Abe. Within that process, Kake Gakuen took part the Council on National Strategy Special Zones from the first meeting. Participation in this council is restricted for those with vested interests. Despite that, it came to light that all evidence of the presence of the school at those deliberations was deleted from the minutes. For his part, Mr. Abe refused to take responsibility for any of these developments. He claims the minutes are all open for public access without any trace of suspicion. I will confirm to vigorously I will continue to vigorously pursue the Moritomo and Kake school scandals from here on as well. This stance stems from my belief that these scandals are chilling symbols of the so-called appropriation of the nation for personal use that in turn suggests a shift toward a dictatorship mode. Japan is a state based upon the rule of law and a democratic nation. And in the event that the learning of our government becomes distraught to the point of ignoring the procedures determined by law and channeling special gains to the friends to Mr. Abe, such practices a clear evidence of dictatorship. In addition to the Moritomo and Kake school scandals, there is the issue of suspension of an arrest warrant in a case of incapacitated rape. That matter is currently being investigated by a nonpartisan group of lawmakers. On November 7th last year, I launched the nonpartisan group to investigate the incapacitated rape arrest warrant suspension issue. The group met three times during the special diet session and questioned Shiori Ito about the incident. During last year's ordinary diet session, the criminal law on sexual crime was broadly revised for the first time in 110 years, that is, since it was enacted in 1907. Unfortunately, however, Japan has yet established a rape relief center, that is, a one-stop service providing emergency support for victims, preservation of evidence, and physical and mental care. I will be working hard to gain passage of the Sexual Crimes Victims Support Bill, lawmaker initiated legislation that was previously withdrawn, to help families support such victims. This issue generated harsh public criticism of government party members and Mr. Abe's following the decision to not indict the committee for the inquest of prosecution also issued a ruling equivalent to non-prosecution. This prompted claims of human rights violations and unfair invention by Diet members in judicial matters. Such criticism, however, falls short of the true and proper target. With sexual crime, the authorities have already recognized the difficulties in issuing arrest warrants. In this case, a warrant was produced and investigators were preparing to make an arrest. Despite that, this sudden suspension of the warrant directly before the arrest was pointed out as being extremely irregular. In view of this, checking to see whether the judicial administration was conducted properly is a natural course of action for any member of the legislative branch. This is an extension of the spirit of the separation of executive, legislative, and judicial powers, a key part of the quest to halt reckless use of power. I also wish to comment on the composition of the committees for the inquest of prosecution. These members are chosen from the ranks of general elite voters by drawing lots. This is truly one example of modern day black box administration. Due to the closed door principle of the inquest of prosecution law, there is absolutely no knowledge of who conduct these inquests, when they are held, or the type of evidence presented. I first became aware of the inconsiderances of these committees some time ago, especially back in 2009 when House of Representatives members and current Liberal Party leader Ichiro Ozawa, head of the Democratic Party of Japan at the time, were on the verge of achieving a change in the government regime that made Mr. Ozawa a leading candidate for the next prime minister. However, the scandal, the Gusankai incident, sucked of Mr. Ozawa's political power. In that case, it later became clear that the Special Investigation Department of the Tokyo District Public Prosecutor's Office issued an investigative report to the committees for the inquest of prosecution that was in total conflict with the facts. In 2013, I was behind the submission of a lawmaker and initiated a legislative bill to revise the law of committees for inquest of prosecution. Unfortunately, that bill was withdrawn. Nevertheless, to address the courage displayed by Shiori Ito as well, I remain staunchly determined to decisively dealing with this issue. So, we have the Moritomo and Kake school scandal and the arrest suspension in the case of Ms. Ito. As far as I am concerned, all these cases may be described as Abe Pyle scandals, or as 3P's set appropriation of the Japanese nation for personal use. Now, the top man in power in Japan, despite strong suspicion of such personal appropriation of our national assets, is determined to amend the Constitution. The document is, in other words, designed to curb that power and protect people's rights. He has even proposed a schedule for that process. It is time for the good people of Japan, true holders of sovereign power in this nation, to raise their voices in more vocal opposition to this shameless endeavor. Reflecting on history, when runaway power is not contained, there are tragic consequences for the countries involved. Today, with missile launches and nuclear testing in North Korea, the severity and tension of our security environment is mounting. It is exactly at such times, therefore, that meticulous information disclosure, humble attitudes by those in power, and extremely restrained use of that power is crucial. I take great pride in the fact that for the past 70 plus years, since the end of World War II, the Japanese people have enjoyed the blessing of a peace-loving nation. On the cornerstone of the present constitution, the proof of this statement lies in the fact that despite the constitution revision campaign by Mr. Abe, opinion polls tell us that the majority of Japanese are particularly negative about any changes in Article 9. 政治とは生活である。It means politics is people's life. In other words, good government is a key to good living. Clearly, the mission of government and of all political mechanisms is to work out solutions to unjust conditions that we cannot resolve individually. Within a society, that is, in which everyone, women, men, children, the elderly, those with disabilities, and those without them, may live in happiness, prosperity, and peace. Next Monday, the ordinary session of the Diet opens. Japan finds itself run by a government dominated by the Liberal Democratic Party and particularly Mr. Shinzo Abe. For myself, I will be doing everything in my power to rigidly monitor on the action of this government, regardless of how harsh the criticism may grow. I will pursue the stated aim of the Liberal Party, namely, government that puts people's lives first. Thanks so much. ありがとうございました。
はい、よろしくお願いします。東京新聞の社会部の望月磯子と申します。森裕子さんは国会で見る限りすごい声が張りがあってですね、しかもドスが効いてて怖い、恥ずかしくないんですかって言って、こう目に涙を溜めてる文科省の局長とか見ると怖いな。でもそれによってもう様々なこういくつものこう彼女の情熱によって新たな証拠を出し、それがまあ報道でと出て、あの盛りかけ問題に関してはすごくあの国会そしてメディアのそして世論を変えていったと。でそういう意味で見てたので、とにかく近づけない人と思ってたんですが、出版社の小川さんから、まあ、一緒に対談をして追及力をやりましょうという話を聞いたときは、ちょっと怖いんですけどって言うので一回お断りしたんです。あのしかし、
So good afternoon, my name is Isoko Mochizuki of the Tokyo Shimbun, a reporter with the Social Issues Division. Whenever we see Ms. Mori in the Diet, remember having a very strong and fierce voice when she's questioning, you know, asking bureaucrats from the different ministries and so on, making them feel so, well, fearful or ashamed so much that they even have tears in their eyes at times. You can really see that through this fierce passion of hers, she has been able to bring out various information, truth and facts and so on about issues including, for example, the Moritomo and Kake scandals within the Diet, but also for these truths for the media and the public as well. Therefore, when I first had the offer from the publishers to have a discussion together in order to put this together into a book at all, she's a little bit fierce and scary. I don't think I can do that. And I actually refused this offer from the publisher once.
で、あのやはりぜひと2人の共通でやはり追及力だということで、お話をさせていただくうちに、あの政治家というのは社会部の立場から見るともう常にですね、こう政治でもあの選挙でも何でも裏金をもらったら OK に出るみたいな悪いイメージしかなかったんですね。しかしやっぱり彼女の政治活動を通じて、まあ、いかにですねその疑問や政策についてもう本当に掘り下げてですね、官僚を呼びながらお話を聞いて、政策に詳しい方を聞いてお話を聞いて、それをこう自分の中で消化して、国会の質問とか委員会の質疑に当てているかということを知りまして、やはり政治家のやっぱりある意味すごい力と、まあ、努力、そしてやっぱり森さん独特のやはり情熱ですね、このことは絶対に暴いてやるぞという思いの強さで、やはりあの国会の場に立っていただいているということを初めて知りました。なのでやはりあのすごく信念を持った政治家の方がたくさんいるということを知れた非常に良い機会でした。でその2人の思いをこの一冊の追求力という本にまとめさせていただきました。
However, after having this offer, I've first seen that we also had this point in common about the real will to pursue problems very deeply, or tsikyūryoku, as we refer to it in Japanese. Therefore, seeing her as a politician also, well, I had usually been working within the social issues division in the newspaper, meaning that when we're working or reporting about politicians, it's about, you know, money, corruption, and so on at the time of elections, or this very bad negative image in some respects. However, through the discussion together with Ms. Mori, I could see also the way that she asks these questions, digs deep into policy issues, and really pursues problems in this way, and looks deeply at these policies as well, digests them in her own way, and then uses these for posing questions in the Diet and various committees as well. I came to learn her position as a politician and the presence of politicians within Japan who are really working with great strength and efforts, and also in Ms. Mori's case, passion to dig deep and pursue these problems there very much. Therefore, through this opportunity, I was able to learn about or see, experience such a person within the Diet and see how this is influencing within politics.
そしてですね、私がやはり有名になったのは6月6日、そして6月8日の初めて、菅官房長官の会見に乗り込んだ、その時の質疑がかなり、この声ですけども注目されたと思います。
And I first became to be rather well known at the timing of giving questions at the press conference by Chief Cabinet Secretary Mr. Suga on the 6th and 8th of June. And well, in the voice that I'm questioning this way, this was where I became to be well known for this.
で私がそこに、至るまでに至ったこの動機というのが、いくつかあるんですが、その一つがまず出産後にですね、取材テーマということで経済部に復帰してからいただいたテーマが無給室という問題でした。これは2014年の4月にですね、第2次安倍政権で、防衛装備移転三原則という、無給室解禁ということを21人の閣僚によって閣議決定したという動きです。
And personally, what led me to come to this position after giving birth to my children, I started to report deeply or investigate on the issue of arms exports policy within Japan as my principal theme. During the second Abe administration in April 2014, there was the cabinet decision made by members of the cabinet at that time.To change Japan's policy regarding arms exports to introduce three principles on the transfer of defense equipment and had this significant change in policy.
1967年に佐藤栄作当時の首相が武器を海外とともに作らない、そして作っても国外に売らないという政策を推し進めていた日本が防衛武器輸出解禁の動きとともに海外とともに武器を作り、そして海外に武器を売っていくという方向に大きく舵を切りました。
And so these principles against arms manufacture and export, which have been in Japan since the then Prime Minister Sato Eisaku put them in place in 1967, had prevented Japan throughout these years from both manufacturing and exporting to other countries equipment or weapons. Japan lifted this ban, which had been in place for many decades, and became a country which, well, a significant change to manufacture and also sell weapons overseas.
そして今度は昨年、郵軍記者として手掛けたテーマが森かけ疑惑でした。森友問題では先ほどお話出ましたけれども、国有地売却をめぐって8億円超の値引きがされたのではないかと、取引をめぐる経緯の不自然さが浮き彫りになった出来事でした。
And the second main theme which I was focusing on primarily last year was the issue of the Moritomo and Kakeo Morikake scandals, which has been mentioned now. Of course, this is the scandals around the so-called around 800 million yen discount for the sales of state-owned land and the debate around this.
そして家計問題では、総理のご意向という、文書が出てきました。愛媛県今治市に獣医学部の設置が、総理のご意向によって促されたという報道が朝日新聞を、筆頭に始まりました。そして前川前文科事務次官ほか、匿名での文科省の職員らの告発というのも続きました。
And following this, of course, came the Kake scandal when documents came to light talking about the construction of a new veterinarian school in Imabari in Ehime Prefecture, according to the documents at the will of the Prime Minister. This was first released as a scoop by the Asahi Shimbun and came to follow also by many bureaucrats, including former Ministry of Education bureaucrat Mr. Maekawa, speaking out about these issues and reporting on this scandal.
文書の内容を含めてですね、官邸は強くこれを否定しまして、結果、選挙で自公が圧勝した後、獣医学部の設置が認められ、本年度4月以降に加計学園の獣医学部新設が決まっています。
And following this, of course, there was further documents and the contents which continued to come out. However, from the government, there has been a continued denial in regards to these documents. And the decision, as it stands, by the government is to go forward with the construction of this school from April of this year.
そしてその2つが続いた後、伊藤詩織さん、先ほどお話ちょっと出ましたけれども、フリージャーナリストの詩織さんが TBS の元記者の男性から就職の相談をした際にレストランに行き、三鴨支所目のレストランで記憶を失い、気づいた時には都内のホテルで性的暴行を受けたということで、被害届を出し、準強姦容疑の逮捕令状が2015年6月8日に高輪署から出るという事件にへの取材に着手しました。
And following these two scandals which continued last year, there was the case of Ms. Ito Shiori, the freelance journalist who was also mentioned already today. This was the case where she reported of experiencing sexual violence at a hotel within Tokyo, having gone to a restaurant to consult about potential jobs with a man who was working as a reporter with TBS.
Hi.元記者の男性は現在も合意の上での性行為だったというふうに言っておりますが、詩織さんは今民事の場で争いを始めております。
And the male reporter who is accused of this crime continues to say that there was consent in this case. However, Ms. Ito has proceeded and there is a civil case in proceedings at the moment in the court.
逮捕の6月2015年6月8日ですね、逮捕の当日、成田空港に降り立つ、元記者を待っていた際に、この令状を取っていた高輪署の刑事に、当時の警視庁の刑事部長である、中村板さんという方が、間接的にですけれども逮捕の執行は見送れという指示を出したということです。これによって逮捕の執行は見送られ任意での取り調べということに切り替わりました。
And on the date so after the arrest warrant had been issued for this former TBS reporter and the detectives were at Narita Airport awaiting his return to Japan. The detectives were there in place, however, the warrant was actually withdrawn under the indirect orders of Mr. Itaru Nakamura, who was the top of the Chief Investigation Division within the Tokyo Metropolitan Police at the time. Following this, the arrest was ceased and changed the format of that situation.
逮捕令状を取ることは、警視庁の広報、それから警視庁一課にも、こういうことで TBS の職員を逮捕しますという根回しまでしておりました。しかしながらですね、この捜査、任意での捜査の結果、1年半後、2016年の7月に元記者の不起訴処分というのが決定します。
And so following the withdrawal of this arrest warrant, there was also for the subject and so on which went on in regards to the case. However, in July of 2017, the announcement was made that the former TBS journalist would not be indicted for this.
かつその本、彼が不起訴になる1ヶ月前の2016年の6月、この元記者の方が検討者から総理という、本を出しまして、 JR や都内地下鉄に全面広告が出て、一躍安倍総理に最も食い込む男性記者として有名になりました。
However, just 1 month before this, in June of the same year, was actually when this former TBS journalist released the book called Prime Minister by the publishing in Bosa. This was widely advertised everywhere throughout Tokyo, advertisements in the trains, in the subways, and so on. And he was known as being the reporter who was closest to Prime Minister Abe.
1ヶ月後の不起訴ということがもし起訴された場合、その総理という本を書いた方が、準強姦の被告人というふうになるわけですね。この不起訴になる状況を知らずして、言動者サイドが本当に著書を出版ということを決めたのか、何らかの不起訴の方向というのをある程度分かった上で出版できたのではないか、そういう疑問を強く持ちました。
And at the time, we also had very strong questions in regards to the fact that this book was published just 1 month before this went to the all not being indicted as well. From the side of the publisher, for example, if they would consider that just 1 month.Later, there would be the potential indictment of the author of this book. However, whether they could perhaps predict or understand that there would be some kind of involvement to prevent his indictment at that time, whether there was some kind of involvement, is that which is something we should also question.
私は10年以上、社会部の記者をした経験として、準強姦や強姦の逮捕令状を積極的に取れる、その警察のトップがですね、自らその執行を取りやめるということは経験したことがありませんでした。
I had been working in the social division, which is responsible for crimes and so on, for more than 10 years. However, this was the first time When I ever came across a case of either accused rape or incapacitated rape where the top of the police was actually involved in directly withdrawing such an arrest.
そういうことを踏まえても、今までですね、警察の捜査をチェックする検事が組織犯罪対策などでトップの逮捕に、少し待ったとストップをかけたことはありますが、警察自らがかけたということは非常にショッキングな出来事でした。
In such cases or similar situations, there had been times, for example, when there had been temporary stopped and so on put on while investigations were going on by detectives and so on. However, for this to be stopped on from the police side themselves is something which is very shocking.
中村さんというのは菅官房長官の秘書官も長期にわたって務め、また枝野さんが官房長官だった時も長期にわたって秘書官を務め、与野党を超えてですね、政権の信頼も厚いというふうに聞いていた方です。
And Mr. Nakamura had actually served for many years as the secretary to Chief of Cabinet Suga. At the time when Mr. Edano was Chief of the Cabinet Secretary as well, he had also served as a secretary. Therefore, he was known to be someone with very close ties to the government.
この逮捕を見送ったことについて、記者等々の取材に中村さんは、元記者のことはよく知らなかった。しかしながら、やはり、クラブ記者に所属するメディアの記者であるからこそ、慎重な捜査をしろというふうに指示をしたということをお話ししておりますと聞いています。
In various interviews with media and so on, Mr. Nakamura said that he did not know in detail or did not know closely about the journalist who was being accused of this crime. However, did express that they were paying somewhat caution in regards to an investigation of someone affiliated with a media.
もし記者クラブの記者だからということでですね、逮捕が見送られたということであれば、まあ、一般の方だったら逮捕をしたということですね、そういうような、性犯罪被害者に寄り添った捜査をしていくということを、昨年にも国会で決議が出ております、まあ、そういうことにも反する判断だったのではないかという疑念が、つきません。
And not only the member of a media, but a member of the media affiliation with the press club. So if we consider the fact that perhaps the arrest was postponed or withdrawn because of the fact that the journalist was a member of the press club, and we consider, well, if it was a member of the general public, would the arrest have gone ahead? We look at the resolutions passed at the Diet last year in regards to sexual crimes as well. This is something which I'm going to go against these and something of which we should be questioning.
武器輸出によって経済政策が大きく変わっていく、そして家計問題に関してはつかさつかさでやってきた、官僚の在り方も大きく歪められていく、そして処理さんに関しては、司法の場までもしかしたら歪められている可能性があるというさまざまな疑惑が続いたことで、まあ、だんだんいても立ってもいられなくなりまして、まあ、自らですね、安倍首相の会見は非常に制限されており、ほとんど手を挙げても指されませんので、当時はさせていただくことができた菅さんのところにぜひ取材し、まあ、この疑問疑念をぶつけたいということで参加するようになりました。
So when we consider these different issues, the arms export policy and how this changed the economic policies of Japan, the Kake scandal and how this is shaking the bureaucracy of the country, and Ms. Shiori's case, which is also looking at the impact of the judiciary here in Japan. Seeing these questions and these scandals, well, I couldn't just sit there and take them without looking into them further anymore. Of course, Prime Minister Abe's press conference are very much controlled or limited. Even if you do attend and raise your hand, it's very unlikely that you will be able to make any questions. Therefore, I decided that I wanted toattend Mr. Suga's press conference where it is more possible to be able to actually pose questions and pursue these issues.
それが大体メインの一章等々で触れられていますが、2章以降は菅さんへの会見を通じて感じた、まあ、今の安倍政権による民主主義への軽視、そしてそれをまあ許してしまっていると見えるような、まあ、マスメディアの問題についても触れております。
And so that is the main issue of the first chapter of our book. The second chapter is looking particularly into the press conferences of Mr. Suga and my experiences there, particularly how it has made me to feel how the current government is looking down upon the democracy of Japan at the moment, and also questions regarding the stance of the media here also.
菅さんへの会見では、去年の6月、私と、まあ、ジャパンタイムズの吉田玲二さんというあの名物編集員の方が、まあ、繰り返し質問した後に、まあ、加計学園のでの文科省による再調査という流れが決まっていきました。
And within the press conferences of Mr. Suga in June of last year, myself together with Yoshida Leiji, a great editor of the Japan Times, through our repeated questioning at these press conferences, re-investigation into the Kake issue was opened.
当時はその日はまあ20分で自分では忘れていたんですが、23問も繰り返しまあ追及をしておりました。
And I'd actually forgotten myself, but actually on that time, within 20 minutes, I had 23 questions at that press conference you got.
そして以降ですね、私だけでなく、朝日新聞の政治部の記者である南明記者も、まあ、質問に加わるようになりまして、官邸会見の追及の空気が、まあ少し変わっていきました。
And at that time,、as well as me, also 南明of the 朝日新聞 also joined this pursuing and this questioning, and we were able to somewhat change the atmosphere of these press conferences.
しかし、まあ、8月の半ばですね、お盆休み中に、総理の秘書官の方が菅さんの担当等の政治部の記者に対して、オフレコの場でですね、いつまで望月と南をあのようにいさせるんだと、あの2人は菅さんが4年まで通い続けるつもりだと、10年目ぐらいの記者がたくさんいる中で、なんとかならないのかという話をしていたということを聞きました。
However, in mid-August of last year, during the Obon holidays,we heard that a secretary of the Prime Minister's office came to the reporters of the political divisions who were affiliated there and off record、said to them, well, when are you going to keep, how long are you going to keep Mochizuki and Minami attending these press conferences? How long are you going to keep letting them ask these kind of questions? Can't you do something about them? I've heard that such a conversation took place.
彼の発言がどう影響したか分かりませんが、その後8月末以降ですね、政治部の、菅さんの番記者さんに対して官邸サイドがですね、今までの番記者にはこれまで通り質問させるが、望月磯子の質問は制限したいというような、打診をしたそうです。
And I'm not sure exactly what direct impact these comments of the secretary had. However, since the end of August last year,there was a new rules being made so that the beat reporters or the reporters on the politics beat would be continuing to allow to make questions as they had been until now. However, my questions, Mochizuki's questions, were limited.
この要望が一応メールとして送られ、各その番記者サイドはそれを受けたまわったということで、決して了承したというわけではないというふうに聞いておりますが、以降ですね、菅さんに対する私の官邸での質問というのは非常な制限を受けるようになり、かつてのように質問を重ねることが非常に今難しくなっております。
And so this request was made to the affiliated reporters by email. I've heard that their response was not, okay, we accept this, but we received this.、however, since that time, my questioning within the press conferences has been limited, and I'm also no longer, or it is much more difficult for me to be able to continue to make a series of questions as I had until now.
ここ数週間は、司会役であるあの上村室長の方、上村さんという室長の方が、私がこう手を挙げ始めますと、今、手を挙げている方、方々、お一人一問でお願いいたしますというアナウンスが流れるようになりました。
And in the past few weeks, these press conferences are being chaired by Secretary Mr. Uemura. At the time, whenever I put my hand up, he says, okay, everybody with your hands up now, you're only allowed one question each.
そういう質問は1問、うまくいって2問、3問という状況です。でこのようなリクエストというのがどうも、記者から聞きますと、私がその官邸会議に出ている時だけ、発しているというふうにお聞きしました。
And、so therefore、thanks to this week or I am only able to make one question or sometimes if things go well perhaps two or three on other reporters that such limitations or requests are actually only made on the days when I am attending the press conference、
今日午前中ちょっと言ったので最後が私なんですが、その様子をこれ動画で見ていただきたいと思います。
And just to introduce some of the situation, this is this morning's press conference.
消費者団体とも連携をしながら推進をし、安全性に対する消費者の正確な理解を、促進をしていきたい、このように考えます。
次の質問、最後でお願いします。
東京の望月です。ですね、先ほどの沖縄の、米軍機の飛行についてです。事故後に合意した最大限可能な限り続けるというこの、文言自体がやはり努力目標に過ぎず、現状全く意味のない状況になっているのではないかと思われます。なぜですね、学校の上空は飛ばないということの合意がきっちりできないのか、そもそもアメリカではできない危険な 訓練が他国である日本で許されているのか、これ根本的にこれを支えている日米地位協定をやはり見直していくという必要性があるのではないでしょうか。繰り返し核予定に関しては、52年の岩盤規制を取っ払ったというお話をされております。58年間ですね、やはりきちんと見直しのされていない日本の地位協定そのものをですね、見直していく必要性というのをお感じならないでしょうか。
地位協定については、その順次対応をしてきております。 米軍ヘリについては上空の飛行を行わないよう引き続き例外に対して強く求めました。以上です。
はい、ありがとうございました。
すいません、あります。今までも手ずっと上げてるんですけど、もうこの官邸会見見てる人はもう手上がってないと思ってるかなと思って、今日はもうあるんですということを声に出せば、まあ、メモリーとして残るかなというふうので、まあ、指してほしいというふうに言ったけれど、やはりダメでした。
And so I had my hand up for this entire time, also saying that I continue to have a question to ask. However, knowing that those people only watching the video in these cases will perhaps not be aware of this fact, therefore I continue to say yes, I still have a question. Arimasu within this to show how the situation is, and yet he still leaves the room during this time.
まあ記者会見というのは本来政府に直接疑問や質問をぶつけ、それを社会に発信していく場だと思います。フェイクニュースというふうに言っておりますが、ホワイトハウスの会見を見ていても、トランプ大統領の報道官から一個人が例えば攻撃を受けると、まあ、普段は論調の違うメディアの記者たちが、まあ、皆さん揃ってその報道官を一斉に質問攻めにしていくという風景が見られます。
And so, press conference should be an opportunity for journalists to ask questions directly for the government in order for this to be shared with the broader society. There is, of course, the discussion of fake news lately, but even when we look at footage of the White House press conferences, we can see the case, for example, if one particular journalist is attacked by President Trump's press secretary, other media, even if they are from different positions, will defend and continue to ask questions together on behalf of the media.
私はやはり今の記者クラブ制度の中で、まあ、特権を受けながらですね、あの官邸会議の場に出ていることも、まあ、事実です。まあ、一方で増田さんの会見を見ていますと、やはり記者クラブ制度また番記者制度によって、やはり権力に近いインサイド取材というのをあまりにも重視しているあまり、まあ、権力に物が言えない状況が生まれつつあるように感じます。それが特に安倍一強の中で強まりつつあると、まあ、これに対してですね、やはりメディアの立ち位置というのを改めてきっちりと考えていかなければいけない。私たちメディアが何のために存在しているのかということを、やはりメディアに所属している私たちの中から発信していかなければいけないのではないかなと感じております。
And so when we consider the situation of the press clubs in Japan, well, I am of course affiliated with a newspaper who is part of this, therefore I have the ability to join these press conferences, I have this kind of position. At the same time, we need to question the problems with the press club system in Japan and also the affiliated beat reporter system here as well. This is creating through the inside information system and so on the situation where journalists themselves are perhaps not speaking up to authority, not questioning, pursuing issues in the way that perhaps...they should, and this is becoming stronger under Prime Minister Abe and his strong government at the moment. Therefore, we as the media ourselves, this is time to really rethink why exactly, why indeed we do exist, question ourselves about this situation. Thank you very much.
Thank you. We're going to jump right into the questions. Our guests have kindly extended 10 minutes, so we have about 14, 15 minutes. So, questions from the floor, working press only to begin with. We don't have much time.
フリーランスのジャーナリストの津山恵子と申します。今おっしゃっていた、まあ、特に官邸記者クラブ、それから ご著書の中にあった、まあ、政治部の中で、まあ、何らかの形でですね、権力側にコントロールされてしまっているのではないかという状況がなぜ起こっているのかというお考えをちょっと、お二方から伺いませんでしょうか。
My name is Keiko Tsuyama. I'm a freelance journalist. I would like to ask why you think such a situation of this control of the system with the press clubs and the policy division within the media and so on is occurring. What has led to this to both of us?
はい、ご質問ありがとうございます。
Thank you for your question.
やはり安倍総理、安倍一強、権力が集中している。で、しかもまあ、第2次安倍内閣始まってからもう5年経ってるわけですので、権力の集中、そしてまあ、お友達には、まあ、森友家系もそうですけれども、伊藤詩織さんの件もそうですけれども、お友達には特別なサービスをする、でも歯向かう人は、例えば前川前文部科学省事務次官は、まあ、スキャンダルでもないものを、まあ、天下の読売新聞がああいうことを書いてしまうということはおかしいですけれども、ああいうことを書かされる、従わないものに対しては、あのようなまあ、恐怖政治ですね、そういうことを見ていると、やっぱり、まあ、権力 の言いなりになるということのがなく、などいうところにどうしても人間は行くのではないでしょうか。まあ、特に安倍一強の中でそういう傾向が強まっているということだと思います。
Within particularly Prime Minister Abe's government and its own government at the moment, the power and authority is very much centralized, concentrated at the moment. It's now 5 years since the formation of the second Abe government, and we can see this centralizing of power and authority becoming even stronger. Therefore, we see, as in the cases of the Morikake scandals and also the Zito Shiori's case as well, the special service given to pals of Prime Minister Abe. But however, to those who stand up against this, for example, the former Ministry of Education official Mr. Maekawa, these scandals formed around him, as we can see how their friends at the Yomiuri Shimbun write about these scandals in this way as well. Those people who do not follow are brought into this politics of fear in a way. Therefore, when we look at this situation, as human beings, it is much easier to go along with the power, with the authority, and we are seeing such a trend, especially now under the Abe administration.
まあ、政治部というのは、やはりその自分がついた政治家の方が政界で出世していく、まあ、それとともに自分がその権力の中枢に食い込んでいるということで、まあ、情報を取って、一緒に、まあ、会社でもこの政治部の中で、高い地位に、まあ、上っていけると、まあ、こういうことは、まあ、構造的なもの、根本的なものあると思うんですけども、とはいえ、まあ、かつては、中選挙区制の中でもうちょっとですね、派閥が自民党内で、派閥が分裂していると、各その党内でさまざまな意見があったので、各その議員につく記者もいろんな意見を、まあ、ぶつけることができた。これが今やはり安倍一強の中で、その中での党内での分裂というのは非常に見えにくい。そういう意味で、まあ、異なる意見もなかなか他の、まあ、自民党の政治家の方と一緒ですけど、政治部記者も言いづらくなっている状況が、まあ、あると思います。で同時にですね、やはりあの安倍官邸というのは非常にこのメディアコントロールというのを意識しております。で官僚や自民党内の政治家がなんかどういうところに自分たちの判断分子がいるのかというのをチェックしている。で、聞いて私がびっくりしたのは、まあ、釜山の総領事の方がある時更迭になったというニュースが出ました。まあ、これよくよく調べますと、その総領事の方を囲んで数社の、メディアの記者、政治部の記者が囲んで、まあ、お食事をしたと。まあ、その際に非常に政権に批判的な、話をしたそうなんですね。でその時の会食時のメモが回り回って官邸に行き、こんなに責任官邸サイドに批判的なことを言っているということで更迭処分が決まったと。つまりですね、まあ、これ全員の記者ではないと思います、まあ、一部の政治部記者の方がこの官邸のコントロールに使われ始めていると、そういうような状況もまあ生じてしまっているというところがあるかなと思います。
First of all, when we see the division, of course, of reporters who are within the political division, they are signed often to certain politicians, following a politician throughout their career. The closer they are to the politician, the more access they will have to information as well for their reporting, and also for them to also go up to a higher position within the newspaper, within their media as well. So there are some structural and fundamental issues in relation to this.Not only this, however, if we look at previously, perhaps there were more different factions and divisions within the specific party, for example, within the Liberal Democratic Party. Therefore, with more different politicians with different positions, there would also be more journalists voicing different positions in regards to these politicians and what was happening at the same time as well. However, we are seeing under the Abe administration at the moment, it is much more difficult to see these different factions, different opinions, even within the LDP. Therefore, for journalists, the same is also occurring. They are also following under this single concentrated of administration, a certain limitation of opinions in this way as well. We also see particularly media control under the Abe government at the moment. For example, the different LDP politicians checking up on different media reporting about them and so on. One particular incident which surprised me greatly was actually there was a case where the Consul General in Busan in Korea was withdrawn from his post. This was after he had been for a meal together with representatives of several media out with several journalists. However, a memo that had been taken by a journalist at the time actually made its way to the cabinet's attention, was leaked to the cabinet in this way as well. At the fact at that dinner, he had been making some critical comments of the government as well. So once this information was known by the cabinet, he was withdrawn from the position of consul general in Busan actually. Of course, this is not all journalists, this may be only some specific people, but we can see that journalists are starting to become used by the cabinet or the government in some such ways also.
経営レポーターの坂井裕人と申します。よろしくお願いします。2人とも厳しい追及で知られていますけれども、何か圧力や支援などを受けることは今までありましたでしょうか。よろしくお願いします。
I am a gay reporter. You are both known for pursuing your journals, pursuing various issues and questions. I would like to ask if you received any pressure or bashing in relation to this.
Bashing はいつも。
Bashing always.
最近といいますか、一昨年の参議院選挙で私は復活したんですけれども、その選挙の時にこれまでなかったような大変な嫌がらせといいますか、その当選した後ですね、ポスターが焼かれる、火をつけない、これが一箇所だけじゃない、もちろん被害届出していますけれども、ポスターに火がつけられる、あるいはポスターがナイフで切り裂かれる、そういった森に応援すると危ないぞっていうようなイメージを作るための、そういう事件もありましたので、大変先ほどの望月さんの話も聞いていますけれども、物が言いにくくなってきた、非常にこう自由な日本の今までの空気が少しずつ変わり始めているということに対して非常に大きな危機感を持ちます。
Yes, bashing is always. I was re-elected to the health councils in the last election. After returning, as well after this election, there were also various cases of such incidences and so on. For example, my candidate posters being burned with fire or even cut with knives and so on.Not just in one location either, but in many places. Of course, I do report this to the police, but this is really sending the message to people that if you support Moriyuko, well, it's dangerous, these kinds of messages as well. And such incidents, as Ms. Mochizuki has also mentioned, is also making it much more difficult for people to be able to speak up, to be able to share their opinions and so on. And this, what was once a free atmosphere here in Japan, is changing, and I believe this is a very urgent and critical issue.
会見にやっぱり出るようになってですね、一部メディアに必要にこの会見風景を書かれました。半年いただいた方数えたら30本ぐらい書かれてます。で、初めはそれの記事が出回ることによるネット上でのバッシングがあるなというのは、分かってたので、さほど気にはしてなかったんですが、ある時、米韓合同軍事演習というのが8月の半ばから2週間ぐらいあるんですね。でこの2週間の時に、2万6000人規模の米韓の兵士を投入して、金委員長の斬首作戦とかですね、夜間の爆撃飛行訓練をすると。でこの時に、訓練が始まる前から 北朝鮮側が、その斬首作戦とか夜間の爆撃訓練は、やめてほしいと、いう要望をしているという報道がアメリカ側から出ておりました。私当時、ミサイル実験や、ミサイル核実験の報道が相次いでいたんですけども、その度に圧力をかけ続けるという、その菅さんの発信の言葉にいや、不安感を感じていたので、圧力は大事かもしれないけども、同時にそういう要望が来たときに、もっと慎重に訓練内容を対処していくように、米韓側に働きかけはしてるんですかという質問を出したんですね。でこの日に、東京新聞記者が菅長官にとんでも質問、金委員長の要求に答えろという見出しで出たんですね。その後ものすごい望月そこは北朝鮮のスパイやというのがネット上で拡散をしまして、普通のやっぱり、ね、批判ネット批判よりも多分かなり過熱して、いろんな記者とか、家族とかに、大丈夫なのかという心配をされてたので、私はあまり見ないようにしてるんですが、相当危ないなというようなことを書かれ始めたなと思いました。それからしばらくしてですね、
Since the first press conference I appeared in, of course, many media has been writing about me. I counted at one point there were about 30 different articles writing about the press conference, and now I'm working at this time as well. Of course, I knew that there was this kind of bashing taking place on the internet, and I tried not to pay too much attention to this, not to look at this too much. However, one particular incident which happened when there was the planning for the US and South Korea military exercises to take place for 2 weeks, the joint military exercises,with 26,000 US troops participating in this, and also within the trainings and so on, looking at an attack on Kim Jong-un or bombings on North Korea and so on. There was reporting in the US media that the North Korean side had requested for a postponement or stopping of these joint military exercises. Of course, this was at the time when there was various reporting about the missile launches, nuclear tests and so on. And Mr. Suga was speaking only about putting more pressure on North Korea. However, at the time of also having a request from the North Korean side for these military exercises to be stopped, I asked a question at the press conference about, well, of course, pressure is necessary, but at the same time, have you considered also asking the US and South Korea to reconsider the timing or the length of their military exercises in regards to this, request from North Korea? At that time, following this on the internet, on Twitter in particular, there was, of course, huge response coming up on this, saying Mochizuki is saying that we need to respond to Kim Jong-un, that we need to follow what Kim Jong-un is saying. She's a North Korean spy. These kind of bashing and information on the internet began to proliferate and heat up in an extreme way. My colleagues and media and so on were very concerned about me. At that time, however, I try not to look directly at these kind of comments.
でまあ、その後に、やはり会社に、まあ、電話で、私自身は取ってはいませんけれども、海底会見が制限されたのを分かっておらんのかと、あいつは北朝鮮のスパイやで、で、まあ、殺したるというね、いわゆる脅迫電話が来たと、まあ、この時に初めてですね、会社側も、まあ、かなり心配をさせてしまいまして、警察に被害というのは出しましたけれども、まあ、自分のやはりそのメディアバッシングが、生命や身体に、まあ、まあ行為をまあ、害を及ぼすような行為に、まあ、出かねないことにやはりつながり始めているなという気がしまして、やはり、まあ、言論の場でこそですね、文革が必要とか必要ではない、武器室が必要ではないという議論をするのはいいんですが、その、権力の追及をする、まあ、記者にですね、スポットを当てて記事を出し続けるということが、言い換えると、そういう脅迫や、暴行等々につながっていかねないということで、やはりこれもメディアの在り方というのはどういう立ち位置で書いていくべきかということを考えさせられた人物でした。
And so after this, also telephone calls started to come to the newspaper. I didn't personally receive them, but they were coming to our office. They were saying, she's a North Korean spy. Don't you know these press conferences are limited? We're going to kill her. Even murder threats coming on these telephone threatening calls as well. Therefore, the newspaper began to be, of course, worried about this, and we did report it to the police. However, we consider also that this kind of media bashing could also turn to be something which is, in fact, seriously dangerous or have some kind of physical danger as well. When we consider the field of expression, having debate about issues such as military expansion, military exports, and so on, of course, debate is very important. However, when this turns into reporting or bashing about a particular journalist or threats and so on, this is something which needs, well, we need to really question the role of media and the nature of media at this time.
We really are out of time, but I have already pointed to someone. Quick question, please.
朝日新聞の尾形といいますが、一応望月さんに先ほどちょっと官邸の会見のビデオを見ていて、質問の途中にその簡潔にという声が入ったのを見ていて、ちょっと驚いたんですけれども、質問する際にどういう意味で、どういうコンテクストでしゃべる、どういう目的で聞くかって大事だと思うんですけれども、ああいう制限がかかることについてどう思っているかですね。And I'd like to ask for some thoughts from foreign correspondent based in Tokyo, if I may.Because I'm Toshio Wada with Asahi Shimbun. I myself was a foreign correspondent in Washington, London, and Silicon Valley in total for 7 years. And I attended perhaps more than 50 or perhaps more than 100 press conferences around the world. And I have never seen press officer interrupt your question. And your question should be concise or brief, or you have to be sure, because the content.
Okay, I'm sorry, we have to move to the events because that has to be interpreted. So, Kelly, and then you can talk to whoever you like after. So, please.
Very good. I just wanted to sound so.
Okay, thank you very much.
Very good. ちょっと質問通訳させて、朝日新聞の大畑さんです。最初、望月さんにその映像の中でその途中でその簡潔にっていうのに非常に驚いた。So the question was, first of all, being very surprised that in the middle of the question, saying to be very short, so her feelings about this, and also the question for the foreign press afterward.
Thank you.
これも私がやはり聞き出すと、まあ、私、長い確かに批判を浴びて、なるべくショートにとは考えているんですけど、どうしてもその事象にある、まあ、背景事情をやはり理解していただいた上で、きっちり答えてもらいたいんですね、今日も沖縄の米軍ヘリの、また同じ場所ですね、小学校の上を飛んだということで、やはりこれそのものがなぜできるのかという根底に、日米、地位協定、58年間見直されない協定があるんですよと。やはり単に注意したり改善を強いていきますって言うんですけど、それだけじゃ変わらないんですね。 そういう根本の背景にあるものをなぜ変えられないのかという、これ、まあ、大きな話ですけど、伝えていくためのこう説明をしようと思って、私は結構何でも長くなるんですけど、それをですね、君の主張を聞きに来たんじゃないって言って、つまり、まあ、そういうとにかく長く質問するなということで、まあ、短く見ちゃう。おそらくこちらが伝えたい、まあ、疑念とか疑問、怒りというのをシャットアウトして、あの場は菅さんが言いたいことを言わせる場所だと、まあ、こういう設定をおそらく政府側があのやってるもんで、長くその記者が言いたいことを伝える場ではないんだと、つまり質問の背景事情なんかはいいと、菅さんのコメントさえ聞ければいいじゃないかという場になってしまっているという状況なのかなと思っています。はい。
I am often known for being quite long when I am asking questions or speaking, so I do always try to be short. However, I believe it's also very important to convey the background information which is needed to understand the purpose of asking this question as well. In the video, the question which was being asked was regarding to a US military helicopter once again flying over a school where there had been an accident occurring in Okinawa. And so within the question, I was also explaining about the fact that the status of forces agreement between the US and Japan had not been changed for these 58 years. So this background and how this is related to the question as well, not just saying, well, what is the current situation now, or just having a very short comment from the government, but looking at this fundamental background which needs to be explained in this. This is why sometimes the questions can tend to be quite long, but I believe it's very important to have this full background information. However, then I would receive comments and so on saying, well, we didn't come to listen to you, or you know, be shorter, and this sort of thing as well. Of course, when I'm asking questions, my strong feelings or with anger at times as well be conveyed within this. But the government is very much setting these press conferences in a way that they are only set up for Mr. Suga to be able to make the comments that he wants to say, just for the government's words to be able to share, not for actually questions, which should be the key of these press conferences.
Thank you very much, and as a tradition of the FCCJ, I would like to present our two guests with honorary memberships. Great questions, and sorry to interrupt you, but I think you can get the excellent points that you raised because you've seen the world. Thank you very much.